Welcome to Manantial. Today we celebrate the Lord and every mom that's joining us.
Thank you for being with us. Gather your family and let's worship God together.
Welcome to Manantial Church. Gather your family so we can worship together this morning.
Battles, God. Lord, today we surrender everything before you, Lord. We know that in you we have victory, in you we have freedom, Lord. Thank you, Jesus.
Yes, the weapon may be formed, but it won't prosper. And when the darkness falls, it won't prevail. Cause my God, the God I serve knows only how to triumph. My God will never fail. No, he won't. Yes, my God will never fail. gonna see a victory. I'm gonna see a victory. For the battle belongs to you, Lord. And I'm gonna see a victory. I'm gonna see a victory. For the battle belongs to you, Lord. And I'm gonna see a victory. I'm gonna see a victory. For the battle belongs to you, Lord. Sing it out. And I'm gonna see a victory. I'm gonna see a victory. Oh, for the battle belongs to you, Lord. Yes, you take. You take what the enemy meant for evil, and you turn it for good. You turn it for good. We declare this. You take what the enemy meant for evil, and you turn it for good. And you turn it for good.
Blessed to have you with us today. Happy Mother's Day. We want to honor all the moms that are watching us right now. We know that God's plans are always of good for all of us. We're so thankful for moms like you that have decided to invest in the next generation, have marked our lives to get us closer to God. I want us to go into Hebrews chapter 11, verse 6. I want us to go into the Word of God. So I want you to take notes today. And if you're ready, would you say, oh yeah? Come on, let me hear you say, oh yeah? Let's go into Hebrews chapter 11, verse 6. The Word of God states, but without faith, it is impossible to please Him. For he who comes to God must believe that He is, and that He is a rewarder of those who diligently seek Him. And we must have this conviction in our life that He rewards those who seek Him. Would you close your eyes with me? Let's pray together. God, I thank You that Your love is for us today. Lord, I thank You that You have given us new hope of glory in Jesus Christ. Lord, we want to thank You today especially for all our moms. We want to thank You for their lives. We honor them. Lord, we pray Your blessing over them. Holy Spirit, will You use my lips today? Let it be You that speaks in Jesus' name. Amen. We just read a scripture in Hebrews chapter 11 that God is a rewarder. We all have a mom that has blessed our lives in different ways. My mom was a rewarder. She will give us rewards every time we would behave. Every time we would do good, she said, if you clean your room and if you do this, if you do your homework, then you make sure you get a reward. You get a whole dollar at the end of the week if you're able to finish and do everything that I'm asking you to do. She will reward us for being obedient. I don't know what your mom's story is. I have several of them, from a chancla flying around the room, you know, to me running around so that she wouldn't catch me, to having her in my room and praying over me. There's so many stories I have of my mom. What's your story? What's the story you have that causes your heart to be thankful for the mom that God has given you? I know that our God is our rewarder, and we can see His love through our mom. Today we're gonna look at a story in the Bible, in 1 Samuel, a story of a mom that teaches us to pray, to persevere, and to present ourselves before God. 1 Samuel chapter 1, I want you to open your Bibles. Let's go into the Word of God. 1 Samuel chapter 1, verse 1 states, in the name of the Father, the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Now there was a certain man of Ramathaim,
Sophim of the mountains of Ephraim, and his name was Elkanah, the son of Jeroham, the son of Elu, the son of Tohu, the son of Suf, and an Ephraimite. And he had two wives. The name of one was Hannah, and the name of the other, Peninnah. Peninnah had children, but Hannah had no children. Hannah had no children. Then in verse 6 of chapter 1, the Bible says, and her rival also provoked her severely to make her miserable, because the Lord had closed her womb. So it was year by year when she went up to the house of the Lord that she provoked her. Therefore, she wept and did not eat. Verse 9 of 1 Samuel chapter 1. So Hannah arose after they had finished eating and drinking in Shiloh. Now Eli the priest was sitting on the seat by the doorpost of the tabernacle of the Lord. And she was in bitterness of soul. I want you to get this. She was in bitterness of soul and prayed to the Lord and wept in anguish. Then she made a vow and said, O Lord of hosts, if you shall indeed look on the affliction of your maidservant and remember me, and not forget your maidservant, but will give your maidservant a male child, then I will give him to the Lord all the days of his life, and no razor shall come upon his head. There's the prayer of Hannah. She's praying, saying, God, if you will give me a child, I will present him to you. The Bible says that she was miserable, that she had a rival that will mock her. She will mock her and say, you know, I have children, you don't have children. But Hannah goes and prays to God, asking for God to give her a child. I want you to get this today. What are you praying for? What are you asking the Lord to move on your behalf? She's making a vow before God. God is a God of covenant. Our God is a God of covenant. He's seeking for people that worship him in truth. So Hannah is showing us right here the importance of praying prayers that require God to show up. Are you praying for something that you can't do, or are you praying for God to show his hand of mercy upon you, so that you can honor him with what he gives you? Are you praying a selfish prayer, or are you praying to give him glory? Today, as we embark on our day today, it's so important that we pray with faith. Without faith, it is impossible to please God. Hannah gives us an example of a prayer that reaches the heart of God. I remember when I was in college, my mom would pray for me daily. She would call me, Pepe, I want to pray for you before you go to bed. And I say, Mom, I have a lot of homework. I have a lot of things to do. She said, let me know at what time I can call you. So I said, you know what, just to get it over with, call me right now. And she'll start praying over me every day. I was in college. I had told her, I'm not going back to church. I don't know what you're hearing from your son. I want to speak to that mom that's been praying for her son today. I don't know what you've been hearing about your family members, but can I tell you, God is returning the hearts to him. And my mom will pray every day. I mean, she'll last 15 to 20 minutes on the phone. And I'll be like, Mom, you know, I got to go do my homework. She's like, hold on. Let me just pray Psalm 91 over you. Let me just pray Psalm 19. I'm like, that's a long psalm, Mom. She's like, let me just pray this over you. And she started declaring things over my life that I didn't understand. I would tell her, I'm never going back to church. Church is not a place for me. People that go to church do not have high IQ. This was my reasoning. They just let other people dictate what they should do. One day in prayer, God spoke into my heart and he said, are you sure it's in the church that people are being told what to do? Are you sure it's not in those books that you're reading? Are you sure you're not putting your faith on something that's vain? God spoke into my heart, as I know he's speaking to you. You're going to choose where you're going to put your faith. You'll either put it on your education, you'll put it on your career, you put it on yourself, or today can be the day that you put your faith in God and you see his hand move in your favor. Hannah decided to put her faith and decided to pray for the glory of God to see his hand move. He said, would you give me a child? My mom would pray day after day. Every time there was a vacation break in school, I would go back home. And I remember waking up at 3-4 in the morning several times, not just one time, several times I'll be praying. I mean, I'll be asleep. And all of a sudden I start hearing my mom speaking in tongues over me. I'll be, hey, what's going on, Mom? It's 3 in the morning. What are you? She's like, shh, go to sleep, mijo. It's okay. It's okay, go to sleep, mijo. I'm just praying for you. The prayer of a righteous person abides much. Can I tell you, when you decide to pray with faith, God's hand will move. Now, I'm a preacher of the Word of God because she decided to pray earnestly. I want to challenge you today. Wake up in faith. Start rising up in faith and prayer and say, God, I know you can do what you promised. Look at what Scripture says in Ephesians chapter 6, verse 18. Praying always. When shall you pray? It says, always with all prayer and supplication in the Spirit, being watchful to this end with all perseverance and supplication for all the saints. Then Jesus teaches us in Matthew 26, verse 41, watch and pray, lest you enter into temptation. The spirit indeed is willing, but the flesh is weak. How would you overcome temptation? It says, by praying. By praying, prayer shifts the atmosphere around you. Prayer will cause you to be in a place in which you would never thought you could reach, but because of faith, you go into that place of the unseen. You start walking on the things that God has. You start living unto what the vision of God in your life becomes real in prayer. As you start praying, let me tell you, many times the situations don't change, but you change. Did you hear me? Many times in prayer, we're waiting, saying, God, how come this hasn't changed? Hannah was praying. She was in anguish of her soul, in anguish of her heart. And as she's praying, it's been years. She doesn't see her son, but she continues to pray. And God starts changing her. So her prayer shifts and starts saying, God, I'm going to do this as a vow for you. I'm making this as a covenant for you. When you start praying prayers that reach the heart of God, that change your heart, then God will change your situation. Look at what Scripture says as we continue to read this story. 1 Samuel chapter 1, verse 12 through 18. And it happened as she continued praying. It happened as she continued praying before the Lord that Eli watched her mouth. Now Hannah spoke in her heart. Only her lips moved, but her voice was not heard. Therefore, Eli thought she was drunk. So Eli said to her, how long will you be drunk? Put your wine away from you. But Hannah answered and said, no, my Lord, I am a woman, a sorrowful spirit. I have drunk neither wine nor intoxicating drink, but have poured out my soul before the Lord. There's a prayer that God's looking for. I pour out my soul before the Lord. Do not consider your maidservant a wicked woman. For out of the abundance of my complaint and grief, I have spoken until now. Then Eli answered and said, go in peace, and the God of Israel grant your petition which you have asked of him. Look at Hannah's response. So the woman went her way and ate, and her face was no longer sad. When was the last time you prayed and you got out of your prayer closet and said, I know God's got this? When was the last time you prayed and you said, I don't have to worry about this anymore? When you pray prayers that are not for your own satisfaction, but are for the glory of God, you know, as 1 John chapter 5 says, that he will grant you according to his will. If you pray according to his will, if you pray according to so that you can give him glory, God will move on your behalf. Hannah goes in peace, knowing that God had answered her prayer. But she was praying in such a way that the priest thought she was drunk. It's time you rise up in the Spirit. It's time you get drunk in the Spirit and start getting revelation from heaven so you can call out what's in heaven and to earth and pray as Jesus taught us to pray. There's a way Jesus taught us to pray. Matthew chapter 6, on earth as it is in heaven. I want to invite you to pray. Your kingdom come, God. Your kingdom come. Your will be done. Matthew chapter 6, this week, get your family together. Study the Word of God together. You'll see his hand move. As they were praying, as she was praying, God answered. God always answers those prayers that come from a contrite heart. It says that her soul was moved. She was crying out for God, and she was praying for a long time. Say with me, persevere. I not only pray, but I persevere. In perseverance, breakthrough happens. Look at what Scripture says in 1 Timothy chapter 6, verse 12. Fight the good fight of faith. Lay hold on eternal life, to which you were also called, and have confessed the good confession in the presence of many witnesses. Fight the good fight. Can somebody repeat that right now? Come on, say this out. Fight the good fight. As you fight the good fight, you know that God is going to show up there where you are. In 1 Samuel chapter 30, there's an awesome example of what happens when you persevere. See, David comes back with his men of war, seeing that everything he had at home, he was in battle and he was winning outside of the house, but in his house he was losing. Come on, men of God. Can I speak to you now? You could be succeeding outside, but in your home, you're a failure. See, David comes in, and when he comes back home, he has lost everything. It's time you take back what the enemy has stolen from you. When David comes back home, he has nothing. The people with him want to kill him. So David goes and starts praying and says, God, what should I do? God says, go get it back. Come on, go get it back. Go get back what they've stolen from you. When he goes back in the way, several of the men stand behind. They stay behind. They say, it's too far. Man, we lost our kids. Man, we lost our wife. It's too late for us to get them back. Look at what's happening. Look at everything that the world's offering. It's too late for me to take my place. Come on, by preaching to somebody today. It's too late for me to get my family back. I'm just going to stay here. And because they don't persevere, they don't see the victory. But others went. And they conquered. When you persevere, you will conquer. Look at what scripture says. Hebrews chapter 11. And what more shall I say? Verse 32. For the time will fail me to tell of Gideon and Barak and Samson and Jephthah. Also of David and Samuel and the prophets. Who through faith subdued kingdoms. Worked righteousness. Obtained promises. Come on, listen to this. Stop the mouths of lions. Quench the violence of fire. That's right. Escape the edge of the sword. Out of weakness were made strong, became valiant in battle, turned flight the armies of the aliens. How did they do this? Through faith, through perseverance. And then look at what scripture says in 2 Timothy chapter 1, verse 7. Make this your own. For God has not given us a spirit of fear, but of power and of love and of a sound mind. This is what you have in faith. This is what you have in the Spirit of God. You have power, you have love, and you have a sound mind. And as you do so, you start walking in perseverance, knowing that God will always show up. Come on, somebody has to pray this today. Somebody has to pray until the walls come down. There's things in our lives that haven't changed because we haven't prayed long enough. I remember when I would pray and I would say, God, I want to see breakthrough, but I will pray for 2 minutes. Can I tell you, nothing will shift, nothing will change until you start recognizing the power of prayer. His hand will move. And when you start praying according to His will for His glory, everything changes. The story keeps on going. And the Bible speaks in 1 Samuel chapter 1. We're going to read verse 20. It says, so it came to pass in the process of time that Hannah conceived and bore a son and called his name Samuel, saying, because I have asked for him from the Lord. Now the man Elkanah and all his house went up to offer to the Lord the yearly sacrifice and his vow. But Hannah did not go up, for she said to her husband, no, until the child is weaned, and I will take him that he may appear before the Lord and remain there forever. So Elkanah, her husband, said to her, do what seems best to you. Wow, that husbands will learn this today. Do what is best to you. I want you to get this. She continues, she receives the blessing, but she continues to live in the covenant. She continues to live out the covenant that she made before God, the vow she made before God. She receives the promise, but she says, I know that this is not mine. What has God given you that you've kept for yourself and you said you were going to give to Him? Could it be your talent? Could it be your resources? Could it be your life? Hannah receives what she's been praying for and she doesn't keep it. She says, I'm going to take it back. This prophet, Samuel, becomes the prophet that anoints David. Yes, David, the great king of Israel. Yes, David, the one that kills the giant. Yes, David, from him comes the lineage of Jesus Christ, our Savior. Because of one mom that said, I'm going to pray earnestly until God gives me my reward. And when God gives me my reward, I'm going to present it. Would you say that with me? Present it to God. Say aloud, present it to God. What do you have to present to God? You might think it's not much, but when you bring this to God, God will use it in such a way. God is raising up prophets right now. God is raising up people right now that will establish the kingdom as we present and sacrifice what He has given us. As you present to God your family, as you present to God your dreams, as you give Him everything you have, there's a shift that's happening right now. Even as we speak, even as we pray, God is moving His hand. So now Hannah presents her son to the Lord. Samuel becomes the prophet that anoints David to establish the kingdom of Israel, the lineage of Jesus Christ. Revelation comes now to you. What is happening through your prayer? Are you praying selfishly, or are you praying with perseverance? Are you praying for His glory? Do not cease. Do not stop. Look at Galatians chapter 6. Galatians chapter 6, verse 9. And let us not grow weary while doing good, for in due season we shall reap if we do not lose heart. If we do not lose heart. But we got to present ourselves before the Lord. Look at what James chapter 1, verse 12 says. Blessed is the man who endures temptation. For when he has been approved, this is for somebody today. For when he has been approved, he will receive the crown of life, which the Lord has promised to those who love him. Because you're being tempted doesn't mean you're failing. Because you're being tempted doesn't mean you're gonna lose. In fact, right now, if you're being tempted, stand fast. Stand fast and say, I'm gonna fight that good fight of faith. Present your body as a living sacrifice to God. And you're gonna see His reward come. When my wife was pregnant, she came up to me and said, I wanna speak to you about something that I've been feeling in my heart. And I said, sure, what's in your heart? She said, listen, I think I need to stay home. I think I need to stay home with our son. I think it will be good for me to be a stay-at-home mom. She had worked so hard to be a nurse, to finish her healthcare administration degree. She was starting to go into new positions in her work. And I said, listen, are you sure you want to do this? You've done so much to get to this place. And now that you're here, you don't just want to work part-time. What I was really saying is, we need your money. We need you to pay the half of the rent that we have here. We need you to pay. I was really thinking all these things, but what she was doing, she was presenting before God a sacrifice for her family. This is what moms do. Moms present and give the best to God as they serve their family. See, what you do is important, mom. Maybe we haven't told you this enough times, but can I just say thank you? Thank you for all the sacrifices you have done. I'm so honored that my wife decided to make that decision. Because of that, our family is such a better unit, where we've been able to come across and we've been able to unite in such ways that no money, no success could have ever done. But because she decided to sacrifice and said, I'm gonna give this up. I'm gonna give up my profession for my family. I want you to get this. I'm not saying this is what every woman should do. What I'm saying is, are you presenting to God what you have? As she did that, our family started doing things that we never did before, like praying together. Yeah, we would pray together in the morning, but now we would pray together at the time of dinner. And she would say, look at the scripture that we had today. The Bible says that a wise woman builds her house. A wise woman. You can read this, Proverbs 31. It's the one that builds her house. And I want to honor those women that have sacrificed so much today. Can I tell you something? The greatest example of presenting your best was Jesus Christ. He presented all He had and He said, here I am. I give my body as a ransom for your life, for your sins. I pay the price. He stands in the gap and He says, you don't have to live in that sin anymore. You don't have to live in that shame anymore. Would you receive what He has done? Would you receive that love? I don't know what's the greatest story you remember of your mom. I don't know what marked you from what she did in her life, what the sacrifices she's made. But can I tell you, that's just a glimpse of what God has done for us in Jesus. And if today you open your heart and you say, Lord, I want to give you my life. I want to not only pray, I want to believe in prayer. And I want to persevere knowing that you're going to answer. And I want to present everything you have given me. I want to present what I have. It may not be much, but I give it to you. I can tell you, your life will have new meaning, will have new purpose if today you say, Jesus, be Lord of my life. Close your eyes where you are and let's pray this together. Say, God, thank you for Jesus. Say, God, thank you for Jesus. Forgive me of my sins. I repent from my sins. Jesus, would you be Lord of my life? I present myself before you. I give you everything I have. I want to live for you. In your name I pray. Amen. Let's worship together. I believe there where you are, His presence will fall. Is calling the church to a greater yes. God is calling the church to a greater yes. He doesn't want half of what you have. God doesn't ask for much, but He does ask for everything. So would today be the day in which you pray earnestly, in which you persevere in His will for your life, and you present all you are, all you have, so you can give Him glory. I know that as you do so, He will reward you. Hebrews chapter 11, verse 6 says, "But without faith, it is impossible to please Him. For he who comes to God must believe that He is, and that He is a rewarder of those who diligently seek Him." I challenge you this week to seek Him above all things, and you'll see all these things shall be added to you in Jesus' name. God's best is for you. You were called to greater so that you can bring glory to His name. God bless you, church.
What a wonderful message we just heard, and what a beautiful reminder that the love and sacrifice of a mom reflects the love and sacrifice of Jesus.
We're so blessed to be able to honor our moms today. One of the ways we can honor God is by our giving. So if you want to partner with us in what God is doing in this ministry, I want to invite you to call us to the number you see on the screen, or you can text the word Manantial to a number 77977. You can also give by going to our website at manantialchurch.com. Thank you for being part of what God is doing in this place. God's best is for you always.
Welcome to Manantial. Manantial is here to reach, teach, and empower. We pray that this food will bless you and your family. Remember, God's best.